Nobody's going to argue it's been that offense that leads them. What kind of challenges do they present? And again, I've seen bits and pieces of their games. It appears they're running the ball a little bit more effectively than they did a year ago.
They are. They got a critical upgrade this offseason. They signed center Rodney Hudson, who was with the Raiders. He has made a huge difference in their run game. They're much better in the middle of the field, both in pass protection and in the run game. They are running downhill a little bit better. They used to be a team that would like to stretch things out to the side and try to exploit the edges. They're much more smash mouth this year, and it's working for them because you have to, if you're honoring that, that makes Kyler's ability to escape even better because you're going to have your linebackers sucked more into the middle of the field. You know, your outside guys have to respect the fact that, you know, Chase Edmonds might be tacking it up inside. So it's a good strategy move. It's working well for them. The play action, much like Baker Mayfield, Kyler Murray is very good at play action. He sells the fakes well. He sees the field well coming out of it. They're a very good football team. They've beaten some good football teams too. And that's the challenge right now, is to make sure that the Browns belong in that conversation of still being a good football team. I know they're 3-2. If they fall to 3-3, there's going to be some people that are, you know, eyeing that 480 bridge out there and wondering, you know, when do we jump off this? It's way too early for that. But again, it would be nice if the Browns beat a good football team at some point. And Sunday would be a great opportunity to do that because the Cardinals right now, boy, being the team that knocked off the last unbeaten, that would be a nice little feather in the cap.
And Hudson is out, so they've already ruled their center Hudson
out.
Oh,
good! I missed that.
Yeah,
that's great.
So yeah,
that's good news.
Yes.
As we said earlier, they have injury issues too, and that's something that you got to pay attention to. They're going to have Sunday morning, come 11, or it'll be 2:30 in the afternoon when the inactives get released.
Yeah.
It's going to be a very interesting time to pay attention to both of those teams on their social media and what comes out of it, because there's a lot of guys that could play or could not play that will impact the game.